The effect of a rubber balloon on human hair is well known. The hairs are attracted. That's called static electricity. Maybe you've tried that little trick. Perhaps you've tried this trick also. Take an ordinary plastic pen, rub it on your sleeve, and bring it up near some little scraps of paper, and you'll find that they are attracted. Another example of static electricity. What is not so well known, however, is the effect of a dinner fork on a tennis ball. Have a look at this. Bring the dinner fork up near the tennis ball, and you'll find that if you get it close enough, yes, the tennis ball starts to roll towards the fork. So bring the fork back towards yourself, and the tennis ball keeps rolling. Isn't that amazing? Now, you're probably saying to yourself, would it work with the handle of the fork? Let's try that. Bring it near the ball, and yes, still works. In fact, I think I can get it to work with my fingers only. Here we go. Yes, coming towards me, and I can stop it whenever I want. You're probably saying there must be something attached to the ball. There isn't. Look at that. Ordinary tennis ball, nothing attached to it. What about my hands? Nothing attached to them either, nor to my body. But if you were close enough, you may see something attached to my foot. In fact, around my ankle, I have a piece of cotton thread. I deliberately chose black so that you couldn't see it. And when I was moving backwards, I was actually pulling with my foot. Now, what was I pulling? The cotton thread goes not to the ball itself, but underneath the tablecloth. How could it possibly make the ball move? Can you guess what's there? Have a look at this. There it is, a curtain ring. So what was happening is I was moving my foot away, that was dragging on the curtain ring, which was hidden by the tablecloth, and the whole thing moved back towards me. Didn't need a fork or anything else for that matter, but it's a good little trick. Why don't you try it on your friends?